Hello, everybody. Thank you very much for the opportunity to talk here today at the NextRISE conference. My name is Marius and I'm the head of digital innovation for the APAC region at DB Schenker, one of the global logistics providers. Today, I would like to share with you about what I believe is the logistics of the future and more specifically what DB Schenker is doing with regards to digital innovation. However, before we jump right into the topic, let me introduce to you first what Schenker actually is and how old we are and so on. Schenker was founded more than 100 years ago in Germany, is now a traditional company, you could say. We are active in about 130 countries, have almost 80,000 employees and serve about 700,000 clients. This makes us a big company, and we could say, yes, we are big, we know what to do. However, I wouldn't say so, and we really shouldn't say so. Big doesn't automatically make you successful, rather it can make you slow. So therefore, we have to consider as Schenker, what is the future about and how can we prepare for it? And when we talk about preparing for the future, basically for us, this means two things. On the one hand, looking at challenges in logistics. On the other hand, looking at technological change. Let's start with the first, challenges in logistics. You can see a few things here on that slide. I won't go through all of those, but obviously you have topics like pandemics right now, something we all suffer from. We have topics like changing business models. Sustainability is a very big one that we all have to prepare for. We have new market players rising in the industry, challenging us to become leaders, which is a good thing, because then we also have to compete and get more active. And other topics like lack of personnel, tolls for trucks, many, many things that we have to consider as a logistics provider. On the other hand, you have a lot of technological change. If we look at the topics here, you will realize that many of those didn't even exist 15 years ago. We have things like AI, we have Internet of Things, we have augmented reality, 3D printing, big topics now. Some of those the world has come very much used to, but comparatively, if we look at the big picture of our company history, those topics are young and the industry, just as Schenker itself, has to prepare and adapt to those. And now the question is, how do we do that? The keyword is digital transformation. We have to turn ourselves more digital, us as in people, us as in the company, and also us as in the industry. Change, however, also brings about a lot of opportunities. And our digital ambition as Schenker is clear. On the one hand, we, as mentioned, want to transform ourselves, our core business, into turning it more digital. On the other hand, we certainly want to explore and also grasp the opportunities that are available now due to new digital business models. And here, let's delve in a little deeper. I will go through a few examples of how we transform ourselves and then how we seize the opportunities that are up for taking in the new market. So let me share with you how Schenker is transforming itself. We will come to a few project examples on the next slides. I do want to emphasize here, though, that transformation also has to do with how we work. Do we work in agile squads compared to traditional teams? Do we work in offices that we can flexibly change in terms of structure so that departments can work easier together? Do we have areas in the office that allow us to get ideas more effectively? Are we prepared for working flexibly from home if need be, for example, as we are right now? All of that is part of the internal transformation of a company, and that's what we're doing actively. And now let's look at a few examples of projects. Let's start with data analytics. And actually, if not already, Schenker truly is becoming a data-driven company. To give you insights about the focus areas that we have identified for data analytics in our company, on the one hand, we are heavily focusing on predictive analytics. Predictive analytics basically means I have information today and I want to see and understand how this information behaves tomorrow. Then we have prescriptive analytics, which is a step further. It's not only about knowing and understanding how data will behave, but also what kind of actions should I take depending on the outcome of those predictions or of other kinds of optimizations. And here we, for example, do simulations and we do optimizations for our customers and for internal purposes. Let me show you one very specific example of how optimization then looks like at Schenker. Here you see a tool called BinPacker. What is this tool? In the end, it's something like 3D Tetris for our customers and for operations colleagues themselves. What you can see here in the video is also basically what that system is all about. You have the challenge in logistics that you have to staff packages and goods, for example, in a container. And now the question is, how do you do that in an optimized way? How do you use space as efficient as possible? Because in the end, space is cost. And in order to do this mathematically optimized, we have created this BinPacker tool that allows our customers and us to basically give the tool a number of packages, and then that tool will automatically derive an optimal solution how to put those packages in, say, a container. Another truly game-changing area is IoT, or in general, telemetry. It's a service we also call Connect to Track for our customers. What it is it offers live visibility of goods, of shipments. Typically in the logistics industry, you had something called milestone updates. That means that, for example, a ship would arrive at a port and your containers on that ship, you get a milestone update that now that ship has arrived. This means you as the logistics company or as the customer knows, okay, my container is now somewhere around that port. However, nowadays, our customers, and for good reasons, ask for more. They want to know exactly where their good is right now. They want to know the specific situation of that package. They want to know, for example, what's the temperature of it? What's the pressure? What's the specific location? Has someone between origin and destination maybe opened my container? And all these things we can now provide with this service called Connect to Track or IoT telemetry. What we do here is we offer customers a basically turnkey solution. Customers come to us and say, "Dear Schenker, I would like to track a certain shipment from A to B. Please help me with that." And then we do all the rest. We support the customer with the devices that are needed to do the tracking. You can imagine small tracking devices. Some of them look similar to a phone without a screen. We help then the customers to put those devices on the shipments or on the containers. We offer an account in our IoT platform that you can see here as a screenshot on the right-hand side, where the customer can see live information about that shipment. Then in the end, if need be, we also deal with the disposal and the reverse logistics of those tracking devices for the customer. This is all a service that we provide, and that is something that creates high interest and also hopefully a lot of benefit for our customers. One more example of how we transform ourselves can be seen here. Just like I cannot be with you right now, in general, travel is limited. We as Schenker, of course, would like to show our customers and potential customers our locations, our interesting warehouses, our automation in the warehouses, and so on. Right now, we can't. So what do we do about that? We started a journey of creating virtual warehouse visit experiences so that our customers and other interested parties can actually come and visit us. How do we do that? Basically, we use the 360 degree camera technology and connect this to a system similar to, for example, Microsoft Teams, that allows people to see and meet live, with the added benefit of being able to see the entirety of the warehouse. So 360 degrees around you. You can choose exactly where you want to look at, and you do that also with other people. That's a quite convenient thing because it really feels like being there. And besides the benefits of being together during a pandemic, it of course would reduce travel time. It is much better for the environment because we actually don't have to sit in a plane. So that is, from my perspective, here to stay. Let's look at one example, shall we? So if we here now think we are looking at our own laptop at home, we would actually be in the browser and can see wherever we want to see in any direction in a warehouse live. That is the system that we are currently using and testing. And it's really impressive. It's really immersive. It feels like being there. If you have VR glasses, you can even use those to have an even more immersive experience. All right, so far for a few internal examples. Let's take also a look at what do we do with the market itself? How do we try to seize new opportunities? And here, first of all, a clear message. We have been and are working and are very comfortable with working with startups. We have created a big database of startups in several areas. We have worked with dozens of startups and also brought those into then successful projects with us. And we also have investment options as a corporation where we then do specific invests in companies that are of strategic importance for us. So if that's something interesting to you, feel free to approach us. And also to make sure that it's not just words, but I also share facts. Here's one example of a company that Schenker invested in. This company is called Volocopter, and it's a global leader in urban mobility. What does this mean? You can see here on the lower left-hand side, Volocopter is building on the one hand air taxis. This means basically flying people from A to B. But for Schenker, even more interesting, Volocopter is developing the so-called Volo drone, which allows to bring things from A to B. Much more in our business, isn't it? And that is something that was very interesting for us. So we did invest in that company, and we are now working heavily together with this company to make our commonly shared dreams come alive. There are, however, quite a few other examples of how Schenker has worked with startups. And I have three examples here. What Three Words is a rather interesting company. What they do is they create a new, let's say, postal code system. Currently, postal codes, you know how it works. You have a code, and this belongs to a number of streets and so on. However, especially if you work in logistics, you often have a challenge. For example, let's assume you're a truck driver and you have to deliver something to a trade fair. The trade fair, this can be a big place, and it may have only one address. So the truck driver now has a hard time because he doesn't know, or she doesn't know, where exactly on the trade fair grounds the goods have to be brought to. What Three Words helps with that, because they create a system of 3 by 3 meter squares, and every square has its own address consisting of three words, also easy to remember. So in the end, if we have this what Three Words address, we know exactly down to 3 meters where we have to bring goods. Very helpful. The second example is Gideon Brothers. They are building these little robots you saw in the video just now in the middle, and they help us manage our warehouses more efficiently by autonomously bringing goods around. Last but not least, on the right-hand side here, you had a video about Einride. Einride is an autonomous truck provider with which we had a test in Scandinavia. And during the test, we were driving goods on public roads for Schenker and hence wanted to delve into the space of autonomous cars and, of course, very much fuel-efficient green cars. So we just had one example of how we work with a startup. Let's take a look at a business model that we identified and are currently approaching as Schenker as well. And that is 3D printing. 3D printing is something many of you will know already. You can buy 3D printers also for home and can create cool things with that. However, for us in logistics, this is truly a strategic topic because in the end, we're in the business of bringing things from A to B. Yeah. So what if people and companies can now actually print things directly at B and don't have to bring them anymore from point A? Then technically, if everybody did that, right, we're out of business. Of course, it's not that easy, but for some things that is indeed possible. And therefore, we have to take a look at that and have to make this part of our business model as well. Hence, we are now going into the 3D printing service and offer our customers to check with us if their requirements in terms of products that they want to have at a certain part in the world, if those actually could be efficiently 3D printed. And by efficiently, I mean time-wise and also cost-wise, because 3D printing remains a rather expensive thing to do, especially in high quality. And if this has a go, so if it's possible, then we help that company, our customer, to print that device that they need and integrate it into the warehouse flow that we hopefully have for the customer anyway. All right, so I hope those examples were interesting to you. The question is now, what is next? I've shared a few things that Schenker is doing right now and that we see in the market. What do we believe is next in the market? And what you can see here is, well, you could almost say a summary of trends that we see and expect. There are some mega trends like new work, what I had already mentioned before, how we will work in the future. There is the big topic of urbanization. People tend to move more and more, if not already so, into cities. Sustainability, of course, is something that every company in the world has to look at. And in general, there are new business models coming up every day. The one thing that I haven't mentioned here deeply is platform economics. In the end, this means in a digital age, most businesses tend together on certain platforms, and that's something we have to be aware of as well. So let's take a look at some specific examples. When it comes to urbanization, the big question is how do we bring goods also in the urban space, which is a very complex space, from A to B. Some people, especially when it comes then to the customer, call it also solving the last mile problem. And here we have options like drones, as already mentioned. We have options like autonomous robots that we also are already testing. We are looking at much more, let's say, basic things like cargo bikes, which is something very green because you have zero emissions, certainly. And Schenker is testing basically all of those options. Looking at sustainability, Schenker is already doing a lot here. We have a very large fleet of EV trucks. Volocopter, as mentioned, is also flying completely with battery. This means zero emissions there. Reverse logistics, or in general, the circular economy, is becoming a big topic for us and more. Looking at new business models, as mentioned, we see things like 3D printing coming up and other topics like visibility, IoT, that will be game changing. And yeah, regarding platform economics, we have tests with technologies like the blockchain, where we want to create a new file structure or basically document structure for certain important documents in the logistics industry. And new work is something that you would see if you visit one of our offices, what we're trying to do there. So in the end, many, many things that we as the logistics industry, but also as Schenker ourselves, are looking at for the future and where we see a lot of things going on. And that's it from me. I hope it was interesting. Thank you very much for your attention. If you would like to follow up with me on any of the topics I presented, I have here two links on that slide to my LinkedIn profile and for my email address. Feel free to reach out. Other than that, thank you very much for your attention. Enjoy the rest of the day and of this conference. Thank you.